some beautiful night scenes of the region around Granada, Spain, our host for the 27th Winter Universiad. In today's highlights, we'll see men's and women's snowboard parallel giant slalom. Then it's to the Granada Sports Palace for men's playoff qualification action in hockey between the United States and Sweden. And finally, we'll look in on Norway and Sweden in the final round robin draw for women's curling. Soulair Park here in the Sierra Nevada Mountains, the site for parallel giant slalom for both the men and the women in snowboard competition. Nice day, about -1 degree Celsius. A little bit of sun, some clouds starting to move in. And there you see the trainers and the athletes getting some final equipment preparations as they will make their way down a challenging course here in Granada. There you see the trainers, key elements to any team. And that's a schedule of events that all the athletes will go through here today. First, the small final for the women. Daria Groznova of Russia on the left and Nadia Otner of Italy on the right. And you can see the clouds really starting to move in now. And there is Otner on the right, and she will crash into the fence. Does not miss a gate, so she's still in it, but can she make her way down the course in enough time to stay in it moving into the second race?
15.
Each athlete will race one time on each side. And there you see Osha making her way down. And she will finish a little bit over 1 second behind in that first heat. Now in the second heat. A good start there for the Russian, who is now on the right, Ochner on the left. Groznova placed 13th at Universiad in Trentino. Well, Ochner was 26th at the Sochi Olympics last year in Russia. Groznova having a few troubles with those gates there as Ochner starts to close in. And once they come through, it will be Groznova just in behind the Italian. So despite the fall in the first heat, as you see there on the face of Ochner, she will take the bronze medal, winning the small final. Now to the men's small final. On the right, Austrian Alexander Payer, and on the left, Pole Andrei Gaznitsa Daniel. Payer was in Trentino at Universiad, but lost in qualification. And Gaznitsa Daniel, he was also there and finished 31st. There you see both riders carving very sharply as the conditions continue to change here. A little bit more snow. And in that first race, it'll be the Polish border, Gaznitsa Daniel, 0.28 seconds behind. We now move to race number two, the Austrian on the left, and Gaznitsa Daniel of Poland on the right. The pole just a little bit ahead, but he'll run into some trouble there and he will miss the gate and he is disqualified. So now it's just up to Payer to stay on his board. And he will then take the bronze medal. He does just that. So a tough break for Gaznitsa Daniel, but it will be Alexander Payer winning bronze. Now to the women's big final, and this is a big matchup. Selina Jurg of Germany, she is on the left, and Patricia Krumer of Switzerland on the right. These two met in the small final back in Trentino with Jurg claiming the bronze medal. But Patricia Krumer is actually the gold medal winner in the Sochi Olympics last February. So she is a big favorite here and will come through in that first race 0.19 seconds ahead of the German Jurg. Now into the second race. Krumer on the left, Jurg on the right. Krumer is behind early on here in this one. You'll see that she makes up the time quite quickly through the middle part of this course. Very smooth turns for her all the way through, and she's quickly built up a bit of a lead. Can she hold it, though, into the final? And there she is, just across the finish line. And it is Patricia Krumer who will take the gold medal in the women's big final over Selina Jurg of Germany. So a little bit of revenge from the loss she faced back at Universiade in Trentino. Now the men's big final. On the left, it is Daniel Weiss of Germany, and on the right, it is Bo-Gun Choi of Korea. Choi was 10th in Trentino, losing in a quarterfinal. And Weiss was not in Trentino, the only member of the semifinalist foursome here in Granada to not compete in Trentino. Choi almost goes down midway through that race and ends up 3/4 of a second behind Weiss. Now to the second race. You see the snow coming down quite heavily. A really good start there for Weiss on the right-hand side. Choi in the yellow pants on the left. So Choi has a lot of ground to make up here if he's going to try to capture gold. You can see Choi really going for it, trying to get himself back into this race. He really has no choice, but he's going to run out of time, and it's going to be Weiss of Germany who will take the gold medal ahead of Bo-Gun Choi of Korea.
So the gold medal is for Daniel Weiss.
You see the two athletes coming together. And there are the women's medalists. Gold medal, Krumer from Switzerland, Jurg of Germany, the silver, and the bronze goes to Ochsner of Italy. And for the men, Daniel Weiss of Germany, gold, Choi of Korea, silver, and Alexander Payer of Austria claims bronze. It is time for playoff action in men's hockey competition here at Universiade in Granada. The bottom six teams seeking to find a place in the quarterfinals. In the first matchup, we will take a look at the United States against Sweden. United States with one win in a shootout and then one loss as well. Sweden also with a shootout win and then two regulations lost to Canada and Russia. Sweden with only one ever medal in men's hockey competition at Universiade. That was a bronze back in 1962. While the Americans have never actually medaled in Universiade competition, so they're seeking to break that trend here in Granada. Starting goaltender for the Americans, it'll be Matt Cooper, currently playing at Iowa State University, while Arvid Lung will play for Sweden. He plays right now with Tora Boda in Division 2 back home in Sweden. And on the opening shift, the Americans come out with some very physical play to set the tone here in the early going. There's one big hit, puck gets cleared back to the other corner, and there's another one from Connor Schmidt. But it is Sweden that'll get a good chance early. That's Daniel Andersson with the snapshot, easily handled there by Cooper. Americans back on the forecheck. Michael Harris set up there, and that rebound can't be found by Bryce Johnson. Then Sweden on the power play. The puck will come in front of the U.S. net. It's just backhanded wide by Orsvitin. Americans with a great chance back the other way. Luke Hannon can't quite wrap it home. Get a good replay of it there. Then it's Harris again on the power play. That one goes off the mask of Young and out of play. And then late in the first, it's Solorzano for the Americans. A nice job to get the puck through. You'll see it here. And no rebound able to be cashed home by the Americans. Late again in the first, Harris with a slap shot. Young with a great stretch out there on the pad save to keep it knotted at zero. Now into the second, Johnson set up for a one-timer. That's stopped by Young. And then another chance for the Americans here, and that rebound is just nicely controlled. Here in the Swedish power play, Andersson set up beautifully, but that shot goes wide. In the U.S., another chance from the slot, but it goes high as well. Americans continue on the attack, but it'll be Sweden back on the power play who get the first goal. And that's going to be Tim Hertzberg, set up by Daniel Andersson, with that slap shot goes through a screened Matt Cooper. You see just right under his glove. The Americans, another great chance in front. They're being left alone in the slot quite a bit here. The puck will come back to Zern, and that one deflects off of the Swedish stick and goes through Leon, and the Americans will tie it up. You'll see the deflection there, and Young can't react quickly enough. And then Harris again, that one just tips off the top knob of the stick of Leon. You'll see it there. Here for the Americans, Chris Joseph hauls down the Swedish player, and it allows Backeston in on the penalty shot, but he is denied by Matt Cooper. Nice blocker save there by the American. The Americans at Zern again, but that one beats Leung, but it goes off the post. And Leung just reacts in behind. You'll see him there. He knew it was behind him, but he couldn't quite find the puck. Now to the third period. Connor Schmidt in all alone. The backhander goes just wide. And for the Americans, it is Bryce Johnson with a great chance, but Leung with the stop, and he controls the rebound. Now for Sweden, Björk Lindström drops it off to Joel Backeston, but he's stopped by Cooper. Then with about 10 minutes to go, set up perfectly in front, that's Murphy to Hannon, but he cannot beat the Swedish keeper. This one, though, eventually does. Schmidt with the initial shot, and it'll be Bill Balin, who's able to tuck it home. You'll see there the little deflection, and Balin bangs away at the rebound, and it's now 2-1 for the U.S. The Americans on the power play. Perfect cross-seam pass to Connor Schmidt, who plays at Arizona State. And he rifles that one home past Leung. 3-1 U.S. Sweden on the power play. They pull the keeper. And that puck gets shot right down into the empty cage. 4-1 U.S. And that is how it will end. The United States knocks off Sweden. The Americans outshoot the Swedes 61-18, including 24-5 in the third period. They will now move on and take on defending champions Canada in quarterfinal action on Wednesday. Sweden, with the loss, will now move on to classification round hockey to wrap up the tournament. Two Scandinavian countries meet in women's curling action here at Universiade in Granada. Neither Sweden nor Norway has ever won a medal in women's curling since it became a medal sport at Universiade in 2009. This is actually the first time that Norway has sent a women's team to compete in Universiade curling. Sarah McManus is the skip for Sweden, and there you see Pia Trulsen, the skip for the Norwegian rink. Here in the second end, here you see a close-up of Trulsen. And she will come down here and remove her own stone and then spill the shooter to leave the two Swedish guards up top. And now Swedish skip Sarah McManus, who skipped Sweden at the 2013 and 2012 World Junior Curling Championships, losing the bronze medal game in 2012. And she will come down here and set up another guard to force a fairly difficult draw for Pia Trulsen. Trulsen, who as well has competed at the World Junior Curling Championships, is a third twice, finishing seventh both years. As you see her there, able to get past the guards and will actually just tap back this Swedish stone to score three here in end number two. Fans looking on here in this ninth and final draw in women's curling action. Now in the fourth end, Norway scored two more in the third to go up 5-0. We're now in the fifth. The sweepers leaving this one alone. And it will come to rest right in the button. Norway right now lying one. But that does leave a relatively open takeout for McManus. This would be a huge end for the Swedes to try to get back into this game. there you see that easy takeout. And Sweden is back into it now, down 5-3. Sweden's actually clinched a playoff spot already in the semifinals, while Norway still has a shot at the playoffs and a tiebreak if they can win here today. Now in the fifth end, all kinds of rocks in the rings. This is McManus's first rock of this end. And she is counting one as she removes that Norwegian rock from the 8 foot. Now Trulsen. Sweepers on this one right away. And again, you see all the traffic in the rings, leaving this end really wide open. Sweepers working this one really, really hard. And she will just tap off that Swedish stone and roll into the 4 foot. A great shot there by the Norwegian skip. And now it is McManus's turn. McManus's third in this rink is Cecilia Östlund. She actually skipped Sweden at the 2010 World Curling Championships. She lost the bronze medal game to last year's Olympic champion Jennifer Jones of Canada. And there's another great shot. You're seeing some fantastic shot making here in this fifth end. And Sweden now in good control here in this end. But with hammer, here is Trulsen. She's trying to draw here to avoid a really big Swedish end. Of course, they did have that 5-0 lead. Now you see that small opening that she has to go into to try to score. And the sweepers just cannot bring it far enough. And that's going to allow Sweden to score four, and they jump ahead 7-5. Norway scores one in the sixth. We now move to the seventh end. 7-6, the Swedes ahead. And here's McManus with a relatively open draw for two. Pretty good line. Sweepers leaving it alone. They like where this one's heading. And she makes that draw, and Sweden does count two to move up by three, 9-6. Some Swedish fans enjoying this one. 9-8 now, 10th end. McManus facing one Norwegian rock in the rings. She comes down right between those guards, and she will settle it in just inside the 8 foot. And that'll be enough to score one, and Sweden will win this one 10-8. Norway will finish 4-5 and out of playoff contention. With that win, Sweden moves to 7-2 and will play defending champions Russia in one semifinal. In the other semifinal, 9-0 Canada, only the third rink to go undefeated in Universiad women's play, will take on the winner of the tiebreak game between Korea and Switzerland.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world. The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.